In this video, I will show you how to tune a control system interactively using the Control System Designer app in MATLAB. Whether you are learning control systems and want to see the concepts visually, or are tuning a controller for your robot and want to learn how you can do it in MATLAB, this video is for you. But note, this video will only cover single input, single output systems. The system that we will be looking at is the classic spring mass damper, which is a box with some mass connected to a spring and a damper that should keep the box stable whenever a force acts on it. Our goal will be to move the box 1 meter given these design requirements. To do this, we must first describe our spring mass damper as a transfer function, which is a mathematical function describing the dynamics of the system, telling us the output for a given input, or in our case, telling us the displacement of the box due to an input force. To get this equation, we start by summing all the forces acting on the box, by substituting the values for each force and rearranging the equation so the input force is on the left, we arrive to the equation of motion of our system. With this equation, we then apply the Laplace transform and then simplify to get the general transfer function of a spring mass damper. Lastly, I'll use ones for the mass, spring coefficient, and damping ratios for my system. Now that we have our transfer function, we will input it into MATLAB using the TF function. Using the step function, we can plot the open loop response of the system. I want to see values in our system such as peak response, so I will right click on the plot, go to characteristics, and click on the characteristics I want to view. As you can see, this doesn't quite fit the design requirements specified, so we will need to move to a closed loop design using the Control System Designer app. To open up the app, we will go back to MATLAB and use the Control System Designer function. The app opens up with a bode, root locus, and step response plots, which is what we'll be using, but if you need to use other plots for your applications, such as a Nyquist plot, you can add them by clicking this New Plot dropdown. As I said previously, we're using this app to design a closed-loop control system. To view or modify the architecture of the system, I will click on this Edit Architecture button. In this closed loop, G represents the transfer function that we found earlier. C represents the compensator that we will be tuning, which is currently 1. F and H are feed-forward and feedback terms respectively that we don't have and will remain at 1. If you are unsure of what these values are, you can click on a term in this panel on the left, and the value will be displayed below in this preview section. Before I move on to tuning, let me add peak response and steady state value characteristics to my plot. I will also add design requirements by right-clicking on the plot, going to Design Requirements, and then clicking New. In this pop-up menu, I will fill in my design requirements in their respective fields. I then click OK to enter these requirements, which will cause part of the plot to become shaded. The shaded area is the exclusion region, and we want our plot to stay out of this region in order to achieve the design requirements entered. I will also save this design so we can compare our work with this original compensator. The first thing I will do to get our system out of the exclusion region is to increase the gain of the compensator by dragging the bode plot upwards. Looking at the compensator value, we can see it changes as we move the bode plot. Now that we have the system closer to the 1 meter mark, there is a lot more oscillatory behavior going on. To smoothen it out, I will add a zero to the bode plot by right-clicking, going to Add Pole or Zero, and selecting Real Zero. Now I can place it wherever I want by left-clicking. Notice how adding the zero changed the shape of the root locus. We can edit the shape of the root locus plot to further edit the response. After doing a little more loop shaping, looks like our system is within the design requirements. We can visualize the impact of the compensator by comparing this design back to the original design where the compensator was set to 1. If I wanted to do more work in this system, I could save this design and use automated tuning methods such as a PID tuner. But I will leave that to you guys to try at home. Check out the links in the description to learn about automated tuning methods as well as other resources related to what I covered in this video. And if you have any suggestions on topics we should be creating short how-to videos on, be sure to let us know in the comment section. Thank you.